much.
Write down sound. What is sound? So before starting sound, we need to first understand what is waves. Okay? Once we understand what is a wave, then we can come back and study sound as a particular kind of wave. Understood? So in your textbook it is taught in a different way. I am starting from what is a wave and then I will introduce sound later on. Okay? So please write down wave under the sound like this. When you hear this word waves, what comes in your mind? Any example that comes in your mind? The sound picture, huh?
Sea
waves. Sit down. Huh? Then what? What?
Bass guitar.
Bass guitar. Okay, fine. Nice. Then what else? Are you a guitarist? So why are you shy about it? You play good, right? Play well. Who else? Huh? What else? You don't have to stand up, okay? Anyway, you are talking sitting only. Then, any other example? Nothing. Water ripples on your mind. You throw stone on water surface, there are nice pattern, the circular wave that gets generated. Okay? And anything else that comes in your mind? That string, in a string, when you do like this from one of the ends, is that a wave that gets transmitted from the other one end to the other end? Okay. So how this different from whatever you have learned till now? What you have learned till now? Till now our focus was what? Till now our focus was mechanics. In the mechanics what?
Motion
of object. Okay. Till now our focus was study of mass. Okay. We were talking about how mass behaves. Mass has inertia, mass follows force equal to mass m equation, mass has momentum, and if mass is telling with constant acceleration, you can use equations of motion. Okay. First time, we are not studying the mass. We are studying wave, which is a kind of disturbance that goes from one point to the other point. Okay, please write down wave. Wave is a kind of disturbance. Wave is a kind of a disturbance which travels from one point to the other point. Which travels from one point to the other point. Okay. The examples could be as simple as a wave traveling on a string. Okay, you can visualize this in your head that you have created a ripple by moving this end up and down, then this ripple will move forward. Okay, similarly, water ripples, if you throw stone on the water, the waves get generated. And do you think when you throw a stone on the water, does water move to the other side? But it seems like, right? It seems as if water is residing. Isn't it? But in reality what happens, the particles of the water, they move in a synchronous manner. It appears as if water is moving forward. Have you seen those Diwali lights which just does on and off, multiple lights are there, but it feels as if the light is moving like that. Okay, so similar kind of motion the particles do, and it feels as if the particles are moving forward. But in reality what happens? The water particles are just moving up and down. They move up and down in a synchronous manner, and you feel as if the water is receding forward. But water remains there only. Then what moves forward? Something moves forward. It's a disturbance that moves forward. And that is the wave. Okay, so the disturbance which is there in water requires water or not? It requires water, it needs water, right? It's a medium. So just like suppose if you travel from here to home, you need a medium. It could be auto, could be car, could be bus, could be anything. So your medium is car, bus or auto, and you can be like an example of a wave, which is using medium to go from one point to the other point. Fine. So similarly, most of these waves need a medium, a means to go from one point to the other point. This medium could be air, could be water, could be solid also. Fine. But there are many waves which do not require any medium. Do you know these?
Sun rays.
The sun rays. How can you say sun rays? Okay, so when you say ray, do you mean wave or a ray?
Light.
Light is a ray or a wave?
Wave.
It's a wave.
It is a behavior of light to be behaving like a wave or to behave like a ray. For example, if you are happy, you behave in one way. If you are sad, you behave in another way. So you have multiple behaviors in fact. Light has only two behaviors, particle behavior or wave behavior. So depending on scenario, light behaves like a wave also. So when the sun reaches to the earth, how can you say that it is traveling without a medium? Because there is vacuum. Vacuum means there is nothing. Still it is able to propagate from that vacuum. Okay? So please write down electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves or EM waves. Do not require medium to travel. What kind of waves require medium to travel?
Sound.
Mechanical waves. Sound is an example of mechanical wave. Okay? So mechanical waves, please write down. They require medium to travel. Okay? Fine. And we have learned that wave is a kind of disturbance that moves from one point to the other. Now let's focus more on, when I say disturbance, what does it mean? Disturbance means what? The particle having some velocity, but the particles are moving up and down or like that, right? So particles are moving. So basically, can I say disturbance is like just a packet of energy that is going from one point to the other point? Can I say that? Right? So disturbance, which you have written, is nothing but you are transferring energy from one point to the other point by using wave. And you cannot find any simpler way of transferring energy from one point to other point if you don't use waves. Okay? For example, if you have to transmit signal from this point to that point, you have to use waves. If you are using Wi-Fi in your home, you have to use waves. When I'm speaking, I'm using waves. Okay, so there is no simple way of transferring energy from one point to the other point if you don't have waves. Fine. The only other example when you studied about mass was collisions. When one mass having kinetic energy hits the other mass also gains a kinetic energy. Yes or no? Right. But that is not an efficient way of transferring energy. The most efficient way is using waves. Fine. So wave is nothing but when it's a disturbance, it is energy. And in that energy, there can be a lot of information hidden. It could be It could be the energy corresponding to your television signal, could be your mobile phone signal, could be your internet signal, could be anything. Fine? So, even the mechanical waves, now please write down mechanical waves at the top. We have just discussed that when a wave moves forward, the medium, at the particles in the medium, they also move, but they don't move along with the wave. What they do? They oscillate like this or like that, right? So depending on how the medium behaves when the wave travels, we can further classify these mechanical waves into two types. Please write down that we can further classify mechanical waves depending on how the particles are behaving or how the particles are moving. Okay? And do you know these classifications?
Transverse.
Good. So the first one is transverse. So the first classification is transverse wave. What happens in the transverse wave? The particles are moving perpendicular to the motion of the wave. Please write down the particles move perpendicular. What kind of particles? Particles of the medium. Okay? So when wave moves forward, the particles of the medium move perpendicular to it. That is called transverse wave. Fine. Any examples of transverse wave? Stone dropping on the surface of the water. Water surface, the ripples created. That is transverse wave. What else? Tide. Then? Light is a transverse wave. What else? Achha, by the way, when you say light, light doesn't need any medium. Okay, so don't take that example when you talk about mechanical waves. But yes, it is a transverse wave. But that you will study in 12th, not now. What else? Any other example that come in your mind? When you move stream up and down, the wave that gets created is a transverse wave. Okay? So, examples, one of the nice example is this kind of wave. Okay? You can see this is a wave that moves forward. It moves forward like this. Okay, now can you draw this and also tell me after small time delta t what happens to this? It is moving with velocity v, let's say velocity is v. After 2 seconds or 1 second, what will happen to this? This is a wave right now. After 2 seconds, what happens to this? Please draw this. Draw this on your own. Draw both of them on the same distinct page. First draw this, overlapping this, draw what will happen after 2 seconds. The same way what will happen to that after 2 seconds. Done? This wave, as it is, suppose moves forward. This wave will move forward by this much amount. This wave will get displaced by how much? Velocity into time amount. Disturbance as it is gets displaced by what amount? Velocity into time. What is a wave? Disturbance. This is a disturbance that moves with velocity of wave. Velocity is in this direction, so this the disturbance as it is moves forward by velocity into time. Does it make sense? Okay. Now tell me one thing. My original question was, here one of the particle, point number one. This is point number two. Draw this 3, 4, and 5. I have shown 5 particles on, these are the 5 particles of the medium. Initially, when the wave moves forward, where are these particles on the blue waves? Please draw it. What will happen to point number one? It will go higher because it can move only up and down. So this is where point number one will reach. Does it make sense? Point number two, again it will go higher. Point number three, what will happen to that? It will come down. It will reach here. Point number four, go higher here. Point number five will come here. Got it? So all these particles are just moving up and down, and they move in such a manner that when you connect these points further, you get a blue line. Got it? So this is the transverse wave.